Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap 4 video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, the last couple of videos we've been playing around with some images in Bootstrap 4, and this one we're going to create a gallery with a light show effect. So I've got a folder here, and all I've got in it at the moment is another little folder with some images in it. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to be using the free brackets text editor here. You can download it from a link below the video. And I'm going to be using an extension called New Bootstrap Templates. It's also free, and you can just load it into your extension manager. So I've just created a little Bootstrap instant site here, or instant page here. Now I need to save it. Here's the gallery folder that I just showed you. There's the image file. We're going to save this as index.html. So here's the folder we had, and here's our new index file that we've just saved in there. We double click on it, it'll open up in your browser of choice. And here it is. It's pretty uninteresting, but it's just a little Bootstrap template with a nav bar and a bit of text there. Now we're going to use a bit of pre-written code today. And I'll put this link below the video also, from Ashley DW. It's free to download. And they've got everything we need here to create our lightbox. So if you scroll down the page, they've even got an image example there. So let's just copy this whole div from the opening div. The closing one there. Could scratch build this, but just to save time, I'm going to use what he's got here. And if we scroll down, they got a little section with the writing in it. Let's put a new section below that. And in that section, just paste what we've copied. There it is. So we should actually now have something in that page. So let's save that, Control S, go back to this site. Here's our template. When I refresh, I should have those images there because it's pulling them from the internet. There we go. And they won't actually do it. Oh, they did. They opened up, but they're not doing really what we want them to do. And we want to put a bit of space between those rows as well. So what have we got here? We've got two rows. Let's give it a bit of margin bottom. M for margin, B for bottom. And we'll say 4. And we'll do the same thing on the row below. These nice new Bootstrap classes. Okay, let's refresh. There we go. We've got a bit of space in between them there. Okay, well, let's make this work the way we want it to work. And if we look at his site here, it tells us exactly what we need to do. So we've got to grab the latest CSS and JavaScript files from this CDN, Content Delivery Network, which means we don't have to download it. We can just have it pulling straight from this site. Let's click on that link. Occasionally these pages will disappear. The user will decide to take them down. If you're watching this video and the link below doesn't work, email me and I'll be happy to send you the code. So here we are. We've just clicked on this link here. Here's the page we want with the CDN. We want the CSS, which is the actual styling. So I'm just going to copy that, go back to our brackets, and we'll put this up the top with our other style sheets. Here's a style sheet right here. I'll put it below this style sheet, and we'll say open a pointy bracket, link, and it's a style sheet, so rel equals, and it's a style sheet. And the href is where we want to put what we've just copied in between a couple of inverted commas here. So that's going to pull in the CSS. It says CSS here. Let's put a tag on the end of there. There we go. Let's go back to our page. Now let's get the JavaScript. Here we are, the JS. Copy that, Control C. There's the one we've just put in. This is a script JS, so let's put it down the bottom with the rest of our scripts here. So I'm going to drop down one, open some script tags. Script and the source, src equals. And we'll paste in between the two inverted commas there what we've just copied. There it is, the Lightbox.js. Close out our script tags. And let's see what else we need to do. We're almost there. If we go back to this page. Okay, we've got the CSS.js and we've got a bit of script here we need to place on the page. So let's copy that from the dollar sign to the little semicolon there, Control C. And let's put that in our bracket software here. Again, it's a script, but it's a raw script, so we'll have to put it inside some script tags. And let's just paste what we've copied in between those two. There we go. Wait, that should be all we need. We've got the little bit of jQuery script there, or JavaScript script. We've got the correct JavaScript version being pulled in. We've got the online images. And we've also got the CSS styling for the Lightbox. So hit Control S, save. Let's go back to our site. Now when I refresh, you shouldn't see much difference, but see what happens when we click on an image. There we go. It opens in that nice Lightbox there and you can scroll through the various images. Simple as that. Just click off of it to get back off of it. And all right. We don't want their images. Well, you might want their images, but let's put our own images in there and just change this around a bit. So let's go back to our bracket software. And like I said, I've got some images inside a folder called image. I'm probably not going to use them all, but I've got 1 through 17 there and it's in a folder called img. So let's go down and put our own images in here. So in between the inverted commas after the href is where the images actually reside. So it's in a folder called images. There it is. And image one. And I'm just simply going to copy that over here. So we've got one for the actual thumbnail and one for the image itself. Do the same thing here. Let's just go through. Do image two. And with brackets, you can hover over it to make sure you've got the correct image that you want. Right, let's save that and go back to our site and refresh. As you can see, we've got the new images in here and they're working fine. So that's how easy it is to make a little Lightbox gallery with Bootstrap 4. It's really easy. And you don't have to keep it the way they want it. They've got it here. You can have it any way you want with Bootstrap, the grid system. It's just fantastic. Let's make these into columns of three, which means there'll be four of them. And I'll copy this one. Put it below. And let's put in, say, what have we got down there? 6, 7. There we go. Let's save that. Control S. Back to the site. Refresh. There we go. And you've got your four little thumbnails at the top, three on the bottom, because so you can mix and match and get some good gallery effects going. Perhaps in another video, we'll go through and create some different gallery styles. But have a play with it. Really easy to do, and it's great, especially if you're into photography or you need to highlight something on your site. Great little thing to learn. So I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web design, have a look down below and take one of our free courses. We've also got some premium courses down there with some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. So do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.